Hello, 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 everyone. This is Miss B. You are taking an inside look. Hold on, let me turn this Wi-Fi off because you know that the thing be acting crazy. You are taking an inside look at Beauty by Miss B, and we are about to do a lace wig installation. Now, you guys have been seeing this flyer floating around August 12th, an 8-hour boot camp, lacing up the right way. If you are a licensed stylist, if you are advanced in weave and in hair, if you are just curious and you're looking to start in the beauty industry, and you know you just want to just you know learn how to do this thing and make a little coin on the side, because according to the state of Georgia, you do not need a license to install weaves. Okay, so to do it the right way, because you know we done seen some, y'all. Yeah. We ain't gonna call no names. We done seen something, okay? So, we want you to take that class. You have two options on where how to take the class. You can take it, look and learn, come in with your notebook and pen, or you can do the hands-on where your kit and everything from the mannequin down to the combs and clips is given to you, okay? So, just to give you a little inside look as to what we're gonna be learning how to do, lacing up the right way, okay? This is our model, and she has graciously lended us her head so we can show you, you know, the proper way of how to install a lace wig. Okay, y'all feel free. You already know what to do. You can share, or you just feel free to ask any questions. If not, you know, just go ahead and look on here. Hey y'all. Thank you for tuning in. This is your girl, Miss B. Let me get a brush, because with some of this stuff, you don't want to put your natural hand on. Because the stuff is so sticky, it's so, you know, it's a big adhesive. Hi, Miss Deborah, you caught us today. Good. Miss Deborah always says she's missing us. I'm glad you caught us. So first off, you always want to start off with a stacking cap. Well, first, you want to get that foundation laid right. You want to get the foundation laid right, okay? You want the hair, you want all of her natural hair secured. You want it out, you want it away. Hi, Angela. Hey. How are you all? It is the end of your work day. Y'all made it to the end of the week. Be proud of yourselves. You made it. So what we're doing here, we are starting off with her base. This is her base, okay? So we have a new color stocking cap. Now, these stocking caps here, they come in various shades. Of course, you all know the typical usual color is the black, you know, but naturally we don't want a black because this is a lace wig. So we want the wig to, we want the natural tone of the nude to give the illusion of her scalp color. You know what I mean? And we always want that cap to be as close to the skin complexion as possible. Okay? So we are securing the cap down to our client. I'm gonna bring this elastic down just a little bit more. We're securing the cap down to our client's head. Hey, Ma. What is it? Oh, hey, Auntie Cookie. Hey, Cookie. Now, we done talked about this, Cookie. Now, you got to come on here from your page. So we are securing her cap to her foundation. We're securing her cap, okay? Always secure the cap. These are some things that now you're learning via video, but these are things if you if you enroll in the class. It's a link on that Eventbrite. Go ahead and enroll. Okay, so I'm securing her stocking cap down with, this has got to be glued, blasting free spray. And when I tell y'all it blasts, okay? It's cold and everything. So I'm going to help it dry some with a cool dryer, cool air. Soft, because we don't want to blow our client out of the chair. We're going to help it dry some. You You never, ever, 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 ever want to put the cap directly on the client's hairline. You never want to do that. Because the name of the game is to guarantee the style, protect the hair. Hey, Lily Marie. Am I hollering? I feel like I'm in your ear. I'm just blasting your eardrum out.
No, you're good.
Okay. I'm just yelling. Okay. Hey, Cookie. you are in attendance and accounted for. Okay, so we are tacking her cap down. We are lacing up the right way, y'all. Lacing up the right way. We're tacking her cap down. So what we want to do is get this layer of adhesive. We want to get it dry enough so that we can cut the elastic portion off so that we can stop cutting off our client's circulation on her head right now. Because it's just tight around there. Hey, Nakia. How are you, honey? Thank you guys for tuning in. We are lacing up the right way. We're doing a lace wig installation. Go ahead and share, because y'all already know. Y'all know these folks need to know how to do this thing the right way now. This client has come to us. This is her second time with us. And both times we've installed a lace wig for her. And she said, she came in here today and said, Miss B, let me tell you something about that wig. She said, girl, that thing was laid. You understand? She said, what'd you say? I could have went swimming in the ocean.
That's right. It was laid.
She said, I could have went swimming in the ocean. I'm good, Nakia. I'm very good. Thank you for asking, honey. She said she could have went swimming in the ocean, y'all, with this thing. It was laid down so good. So first off, you always want to, when you're installing, you always want to focus on the hairline versus the nape first, especially when you're doing a wig. You always want to focus on the hairline first. You never want to start back here and then work your way up. Reason is if you start back here and you get to pulling up here, you're going to be too far down. You're going to pull. What if it's too big for the client's head? You can't do any tweaking and altering and stuff up here. You have to do all of that disguising. You can disguise it better from the back, right? So you always start from up here and work your way towards the back. Start, apply it here and pull it towards the back, all right? That way you can tuck, tweak, cut, you know, all that stuff. My hair is short like your hair, so do I have to wear a wig cap? Do you have to wear a wig now? You said now, or do you have to wear a wig cap? Which one are you asking? Wig cap? If you're asking, do you have to wear a wig cap? No. It's up to you. I asked my client, did she want to wear, because her hair's short like mine too. So I asked her, did she want to wear a wig cap? And her response was very correct. It was very, you know, hair conscious. She says she would like to wear a cap because she wants to protect her hair, because her hair gets dry and it prevents her hair from drying out. And I said, well, all right then, far be it for me to hinder your hair from drying out, sugar. Yes, ma'am, that's not. We don't want to do the drying of the hair. So I will give you what you're looking for.
Keep those dry flakes under the cap.
Keep the dry flakes. She said, keep the dry flakes under the cap. So you guys, now I'm going around and I'm cutting, okay, wig or tracks. You don't have to. If you want some hair, if you want to have that hair look and you want to have some hair on your head, honey, you go right ahead and throw, you know, Jasmine, whatever the wig name is, Jasmine, Bridget, throw her on there, honey, if you want to. But you don't have to. You know, every now and again, we want to switch it up some. You know what I'm saying? But over the summer, you might just want to wear your own, your shortcut. Because it's hot out here, good. You know, that sun ain't playing with none of us. That son said, child, I'm here.
I see your face when I close my eyes. When you're ready,
so I'm cutting, you guys, I'm cutting the perimeter off of the cap. So it's leaving me with only what adheres to her head. And it in itself is already secure. So you already know what this wig about to do, okay? And you notice, like I said, I went with a new color, her skin tone cap. Please, y'all, please, 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 I am begging you. If you are my color, don't you dare put a cap this color on your head, okay? Don't do that. There are variations of shades of brown and, you know, listen. As far as the world of beauty has come, if y'all don't find a cap that match your skin good, you better. And no, you shouldn't have to put on no makeup. You should not have to put makeup on the cap to match your skin. There is a cap to match your skin, sugar. Stop wasting your good face makeup on these stocking caps, okay? All right. So we, as you all can see, because you almost can't even tell unless you just saw me. If you did not just see me cut that off, you wouldn't be able to tell that she has a cap on her head because it's that close to her skin tone. That's what you want. The illusion is, the name of the game is to hide. You don't want nobody in your business, okay? So now I'm taking Got to Be Glue, the gel, and I am building an adhesive foundation, putting it around the perimeter. In our class, you will be given everything that I use. By the time you leave out of here from that class, baby, you gonna be able to go take some clients. That's how much information and knowledge and understanding you will have coming out of that class. Y'all better go sign up. So I'm putting this on here, and we're gonna do multiple layers because, like she said, she don't want this thing to go nowhere. She ain't got time. She said she got stuff to do, and she ain't got time to be chasing her wig like Trump chasing his. Okay? Miss Debra says, I'm leaning more and more of cutting my locks and wearing a short cut. Then fall if I might wear. Yes, there you go. Look like she has no hair. Exactly. Exactly. Yep, that's what our client just did. She had locks, Miss Debra, and she went on and did the big chop. She did the chop. So they said it looks like you had no hair. That's how seamless this cap is. They said it looked like you just got a bald head.
Mm-hmm. I'm rocking it.
Left, yeah. So there are caps out here that will give you this fleshly look. You see what I'm saying? Where it looks just like your skin tone. You just gotta invest. You gotta invest. In that class, you will have a cap skin tone to match any skin complexion. That way you'll be able to see the difference between them all. Again, I'm building her foundation, her adhesive foundation. You're gonna see me doing this multiple times. Because it's nothing like being sure that it's in there. Hey, Mom. Welcome to an inside look at Beauty by Ms. B. We are installing a full lace wig. Again, with my cool dryer, I'm gonna help this gel out some. And you don't have to put a lot. You can put just enough on there just to give you that tacky. And once it gets to the tacky point, you can put an add your other layer on there. See the spray, it allowed me to just put enough on there and adhere the cap to her head. That way I can cut the elastic and she's not uncomfortable anymore. Now she can sit and breathe easy right now. Taco Bell for lunch. You know they have those happy hour freezes between the hours of 2 and 5. Those freezes, these freezes are $1. And honey, I like to get one of each. It's hot outside. Okay. Layer number two. And I'm using a color applicating brush because you don't want your fingers in this. What was that you were spraying over the cap? It was got to be glued free spray. But in the class, you will learn how to adhere a wig via the, hey, South Carolina, hey, Jesse. Well, in that class, you'll know how to adhere a wig, a lace wig, whether it be with the gel, with the glue, or sewn down. Because some clients don't like the gel. They don't like the glue. No, it was with the spray. It was the can, the free spray. She said her last wig install lasted her 2 weeks. 2 weeks, guys. And she said, and it could have kept going. It could have kept going, but she can't. She wanted to get a fresh install. She got some business to take care of next week.
That's right.
And she ain't going to be denied. You understand me?
That's right.
She going to go up in there slaying that hand. I'm using Got to Be Glued Ultra Gel. That's what I'm using. This is styling gel. It says vertical. This is for vertical styles. It says it's non-sticky, no flakes, crazy hold. Now, I will say this. The yellow freeze spray, it dries exactly how you want it to dry. And it does not leave the white flakiness, okay? But the accompanying black tube gel dries and does not flake. If you use the yellow tube gel to accompany the spray, it will flake on you. It will. Okay. Hi, Miss Kiki. Welcome to the Inside Look at Beauty by Miss B. Okay. So we did our second layer. And we're back to drying. Hello, hello. Hi, Tiffany. How are you, hon? Welcome, welcome, welcome. You all are watching us. You're witnessing me install a full lace wig. And right now, we have already adhered the stocking cap, which is a flesh tone. It's her exact skin complexion. And now we are laying the adhesive foundation. Hi, Rashonda. How are you, honey? We are showing you all how to lace up the right way. How to lace up the right way. I know you guys, like I said, I know you guys have been seeing us and our flyer go around the internet because we are hosting a class, August 12th, Lacing Up the Right Way. August 12th is an 8-hour boot camp. Two ways you can learn. One, look and learn, bring your notebook and your pen, and you can learn all the information, jotting it down and taking an up-close look. Or hands-on, where we give you and provide you a kit from the mannequin down to the combs and clips, bundles, frontals, closures, everything will be in your kit. Because we want you to learn the right way. You're watching and learning? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Now, what you can do to learn up close and learn it for real, because I know myself, I can read and learn, but I can also, my better way of learning is hands-on. Hands-on. Register for the class, Miss Kiki. Now, your braids are fine, baby. Let me tell you now. I looked all through your business, girl. Fine, I'm with Kiki Watching and Learning. Yes, ma'am. Class online. Go ahead. Go ahead. Y'all tune in and gather around the screen. Why don't you? That's right. I want to see you guys in the class, though. So you all can have your own mannequin, your own bundles, your own everything. You all can leave out of here and add it to your service. You understand? Add it to your services. Because guaranteed, by the time you leave here, you're going to be lacing up the right way. Okay? Third layer. Right after we finish this and I go offline, I'm going to send the flyer and the link out again. Or what I can do, let me see if I can pin it. I wonder, can I pin it? Okay, so we put the third layer on. Let me see if I can pin it, y'all. Let me see. Y'all catching me at the end of the day. My forehead might be greasy as I don't know what, y'all. Yes, you do. Now, y'all, bear with me now. Don't talk about me, y'all. Me and this, okay, let me see. There we go. And I just pinned it. So there's the link there, and it's gonna stay there, you guys. Share. Kiki. Share, you guys, because if you see it, if you see other people that want, you said it's there? Okay, good. You see other people that want to, that should attend the class, that want to attend the class, that you want to bless with the class, because you know that, I wish I could join the class, but health issues has me stuck on hold for a minute, but not down the, that's what I'm talking about. Listen, We are in agreement with you for total restoration and healing for whatever it is that's going on in your body. From your head to your toe, you are healed whole and you are back to the original state that God had born you here with. You understand me? All organs are whole. All everything is whole. You understand? Everything is whole. Hey, Armaine, how are you, honey? Everything. And no worries. Don't you worry about that class. I do one-on-one, so whenever you're ready, I'm there for you, okay? That's right. You are not down. You ain't going nowhere, girl. You better speak to that body. You got authority over that thing. That thing don't tell you what to do. You tell it what to do. Okay? Hey, Malena. That's my sister, y'all, in the Army. Second Lieutenant Taylor. Okay, you guys, so this layer, I'm going to go ahead and try to get, look, she said yes, amen, yes, girl. Ain't nobody got time for no sickness, honey. We got too much to do out here. Wish I could too, but financial issues has me 10 months in unemployment. Employee returning back to work August 20th. Listen, I totally understand. Ms. Deborah, don't you worry about it. But again, we're going to speak to your finances too. And command them to come in line with the mission and purpose that God has for your heart, for your life. And if it's His will, it's going to be His bill. Okay? Good to see you too.
God is the source of our supply.
Yes. My client said, God is the source of our supply. And we don't determine, the money and the money issues don't determine what we do in our mission and the purpose on our life, not at all. Okay? If you have a desire to do something, you better put it out there. Faith. Stand out there. Put it out there and decree that it's done. It's already paid for. That goes for anything. That goes for anything. I did a live this morning about declaring your situation. Your mouth determines what you have in your life. Your mouth. And death and life is in the power of your own tongue. Your own tongue. Don't speak poverty. Don't speak not enough. Speak more than enough. Speak abundance. Speak overflow. Speak prosperity. Speak favor. Speak the good stuff.
All over my head.
Yeah.
Man. Woo.
Yes, ma'am. We are trained. Thank you, Miss Bonnie. We are trained to go towards our most dominant thought. And if you always thinking about not having enough, you will not have enough. Whether you think it is or it isn't, whether you think it's good or bad, whether you think you're right or wrong, you are right either time. You know why? Because you have spoken, you thought it, you said it, you put it out there. Change what you say, you will change what you see.
Power of attraction.
Yes, the power of attraction. Change what you say, and you will change what you see. I said this morning, say what you see so that you can see what you say, okay? Say what you see. Say what you want. Say your vision. Speak your dream, your desire. Say what you see so that you can then see what you say.
Don't tell the world how big your
problem is. And don't you tell the world how big your problem is.
I tell how big God is.
Yes.
Yes.
Matter of fact, don't tell the world nothing but what it is, what it's going to be. By Miss B. Listen, I don't try to be doing all this stuff, y'all, but when somebody is out there saying something and I got a word or I can say something towards it and all that stuff, then I will. And I expect nothing less from y'all either. I need everybody to speak over each other. You understand? Yes.
Yeah. Well,
we are accountable to and for one another all the time. Whether I know you directly or not, you are my sister and brother. So it is my responsibility to make sure you're good. Yeah. Miss Deborah said, I believe that, Miss B. I am rich, not poor. That's right.
That's right.
But I give me wisdom to handle my bills. That's right. Absolutely. Naturally. Because when you do, when everything starts lining up with what you say out of your mouth, then you do have to be a good steward over what you've been blessed with. For sure. For sure. You got to be a good steward 100%. So you're right about that, Miss Deborah. Now we are taking. Yes, you better. Okay, believe me, Miss B, I always declare. That's right. Good, good, very good. Well, we are declaring and decreeing with you. Because you know when more than one come together, huh? You ain't by yourself, sugar. She all the way in Miami. We decreeing all the way here in Atlanta. Guess what? You might as well say we right there with you. Now what I'm putting on her hairline now are the adhesive strips. This is the very last part of adhering this foundation, creating an adhesive foundation, a strong foundation for her lace. Oh, thank you, Miss Harnett. I was actually on my way down there to see y'all when I got finished. Oh, you might be gone for the day. Now these strips are very, very, very strong hold. My client over here testifying to it. Again, in your class, you will have all of this. I'm talking about every part of it. Yeah, you're going. I believe it. Lacing up the right way, you guys. Lacing up the right way. Okay, so I have her front. Will all this protect her hair? Yes, ma'am. We actually over directed the cap from her edges, so her edges are not even in play right now. We over-directed the cap. You want to always just over-direct so that the edges are protected 100%. You don't want to over-direct too much where the hairline of the wig is down here. You don't want that. You want to over-direct just enough to just clear the hairline. And that's another thing I've seen too, is people are over-directing too much to where the wig... front of the wig is almost touching the eyebrow. Child, no forehead at all, honey. They just Ooh, whole thing. So now what I'm going to do though for her back, I'm not going to remove, because this up here, we're going to remove the white backing, because this is a double-sided adhesive. So I just revealed the first side. Just allow me room to work. Okay. And it's translucent. Very transparent.
Trust the process.
Yes, trust the process. I mean, I love to see you doing new things. The beauty is not my thing. Not, no offense. Okay. No offense taken, honey. No offense taken at all. Not at all. Hey, listen, whatever your field is, honey, work it. I think one of the problems in the beauty industry when it pertains to lace and frontals and stuff like that is that there's not enough patience. Everybody's trying to hurry up and apply something. You know what I'm saying? They're not taking the time to ensure that it's adhered properly. Because the client leave out of here and child, or leave from wherever they're getting their wig and saw that. And it's because it's been rushed, not 2 days later, the thing starts lifting.
Mm-hmm. My first weave experience.
Yeah, she said her first weave experience, it was lifting right after she left. Out of there.
The weave back here, the closure was back here.
See? She said closure was back here. Ain't that a mess? Like it done got too small for the head. Ain't that a mess? Because they're not.
And my very first full weave.
Your very first full weave? See, because people are not taking the time and not having the patience enough. Everything right now is about money, money, money. Let me get that money. How can I get that money quick? No, ma'am. Don't do that. Because if the people are paying you money, I had a client yesterday. I did a lace wig install on her. This girl said, number one, she said she paid $425 for the wig itself. And it was supposed to last her a year, doggone near 2 years. She had it for 2 months. No, 1 month. And it looked like the wig itself got alopecia. Okay? It's so many gaps and spaces in that wig. I said, girl. She said, well, Miss B, how long did... Yesterday was her first time coming to me. And she brought me that wig. Now, and I can only work with what y'all bring me. So, she said, well, how long do you think I have... You know, how long do you think I can keep this wig? I said... When you take this wig off, you need to get rid of this wig. You understand? Like, don't you bring this wig back out, girl.
How did they damage
the hair? What, the hair was thinning out. She bought that wig, and it was described as a full lace, pre-plucked, pre-bleached, and it wasn't. The doggone thing looked like polka dots on the lace. Angela said, I want to come see you just to be pampered for a few hours. Come on down, honey. I will shut the salon down for you. Hermes said, thanks, boo. I just love to hear you talk and your look. Thank you. Aw. Thank you so much. It takes time to adhere that proper foundation and base. It's all about that foundation. You lay the right foundation, that goes for anything in life. You get the right foundation, everything works. Okay. So we have given her... Ms. Harnett said, some people are not that experienced in that. They need proper training. Absolutely. That's what we're talking about. August 12th, 8-hour boot camp. Okay, guys, so this is her wig. What kind of hair is this? It looks like more of like a natural wave, a deep wave, something like
deep
that.
Deep wave.
Brazilian. This is her wig. Brazilian. It's really, really soft, so she cleaned it very, very, very well. Very well. Okay?
Conditioned it
and everything. That's how you maintain and keep a wig. You have to shampoo and condition your wigs, especially virgin wigs, lace wigs, like you do your own hair. That's the care that you have to have. Okay?
She used all sulfate-free products.
She said she used all sulfate-free products. Okay, so now, she doesn't want any baby hairs, you guys, so we're not going to give her any. So I clipped the front of the hair back. I clipped it back so it doesn't interfere with me placing the lace where I need to place it. All right?
Baby hair when the weather cool down.
Yeah, she sweats, you guys. So she said she'll get some baby hairs when the weather cool down. Okay, so now I'm going to start in the center, take it and place it right at the front of where we created the adhesive foundation, and I'm going to work one side first and just tack it along that line. Pack it along the line.
Certainly not.
Why shouldn't we be able to do that once in a while if we want to?
I know.
I mean, really, what is the big deal? We go in there. We're in there for a while.
You gotta take your time with it, you all. It's no race. You want it to be adhered properly. Okay. I got the one side, and it doesn't take long. Why? Because we have built the strong foundation. Tack it down. Tack it down. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take the phone off the holster and give you guys a closer look at what we got going on here. Okay, hold on here, y'all. It's gonna be some shaking. Hold on to your boots. Where we at? Wait a minute, y'all. Let me turn this around. Hold on. Hold on, y'all. Hold on. Yeah, I'm working. I'm learning. I had to work this day. Okay. That is her hairline, you guys. Turn your head this way. That is her hairline. Y'all see that? Now, if that don't look like her hairline, I don't know what do. You see that? Lacing up the right way. Thank you. Uh-oh. Had y'all on the gangster lean over there. Okay, so I'm just gonna go through and make sure that she is, I'm talking about in there. Very natural, right? Very natural. That's what you want. every time. You don't even want to play with that. Thank you. Angela says, oh, my mom says, that's nice. Angela says, you wouldn't know that she has a wig on. Exactly. That's the point, Angela. That is the name of the game. Wow. Tight work. Yes, ma'am.
And it is tight.
She's looking good. And it's tight. Yes. Lacing up the right way. Somebody says she's looking good. That's right. You would not know that she had a wig on. I'm telling y'all, y'all better take that class. Very natural, yes. Awesome, thank you. Now I'm clearing her ears. Because it is a wig, so y'all know that wig can be going everywhere, y'all. Okay, now I'm going to take my clips and transfer them to the back. Because now it's time to adhere the back. And so this, what this allows is for her to be able to pull it up in a little ponytail, and a little bun, get it off her neck if she wants to. Mm-hmm. Oh, well, so they can see it. Okay. Oh, yeah, let me turn some more lights on here. Okay, so like I said, I wasn't gonna remove the backing of the adhesive here, right? Until now. In the class, if you're hands-on, you will have all of this. Every piece of these, everything that I'm using here, you will have everything. I wouldn't dare teach with alternative product and supplies. You will have everything that I use so that you can be guaranteed, you can guarantee the same result. I'm talking about from the bundles to the frontal, you're gonna have a closure, all of that good old stuff, y'all. Let me cross over here. Now use tweezers to get it up, okay? To get it off. So now all we have is the transparent adhesive barrier on the, it's just beyond, again, the same way I did just beyond the hairline up front, I'm doing just beyond the nape, just beyond, because we don't want to bother the hair. Okay, so we're going to tack it, we're going to pull it down, and again, we're going to tack from the center out. From the center out. Now keep in mind, on these wigs, they have clamps on the inside, they have combs on the inside, all of that stuff. That does not matter. You can choose to cut that stuff out if you don't want it in there, or you can work around it. There's always a way to work around it, though. As All right. Once again, I'm going to take the camera off the holster. I'm going to turn you guys around. This is her back hairline. You see that? That is her back hairline. Okay. Telling you, lacing up the right way. There is a right way. And there is a wrong way. And our client has confirmed that it feels good. She says it's very, very tight. It's very secure. She will have this wig for another 2 weeks or longer. Okay. All right. Guys, this is her look. This is her installed wig. She can part it at any point. At any point that she wants to. She can bring it over here for some fullness that way. She can part it down the center. You know, part down the middle and wear it on either side. She can part it on the right for some fullness over this way. Or she don't even have to wear a part. Just let the hair fly away and make it. You know what I mean? Or she could take it. Take some hair here, lay that down. Take some hair here, lay that down. Take this, she can take this and pull it up and wrap it around in the bun if she want to, you know what I'm saying? Have the back hanging down, or she can just take the whole thing. Put it up in a nice, cute bun. Boom, tack, you know what I mean? And not be worried about whether it's going to move. She ain't gonna shift with the wind, honey. I'm taking some leave-in conditioner. This is a Nutrist leave-in botanical reconstructor. Leave-in conditioner. I'm just going to moisturize the hair. Again, you want to feed the wig and the weaves the same product and natural product that you feed your natural hair. Because it is natural hair. Yes, it smells really good. Yes. Look at it, y'all. Say she is back. She said, I'm making her feel like Becky with the good hair. Oh. Honey, Becky with the good hair. Becky wish she had some hair like this. Alright. There you go. That is a lace installation. Okay. I'm gonna take it down. Give you an up close look. Look at that. They say it looks lovely. Look at that. This hair is so soft too, y'all. Okay, she said she used argan oil shampoo and conditioner.
It's sulfate-free.
Sulfate-free.
You see how I made it look and feel?
Oh, yeah. It's very, very soft. Okay. That is the wig, guys. That is the wig. Look at that. Look at that hairline, y'all. Can't tell me that thing didn't grow out her scalp. Yes, ma'am. Okay, say goodbye to the people.
Bye-bye.
All right, you guys. Thank you all so very much for tuning in and viewing. You see the link. It is pinned below. If you are ready for this class, lacing up the right way, click that link. I'm telling you, we will not let you down. Okay? Thank you so much again for tuning in, taking an inside look at Beauty by Miss V. We installed a full head lace wig on our lovely model. She was so lovely, don't you agree? Okay, Miss Harness says, how long does she wear it again before she needs to have it installed again? She actually wore the last install for 2 weeks, but she could have worn it more. She could have worn it longer. She just wanted to have a fresh look, so she came back today, which was 2 weeks after the first installation. Nice work, Niece. Thank you. All right, boo, take care. Thank you for the, okay. Thank you for the sex. Yes, ma'am. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, you guys. Have a good one. Thank you again for tuning in. Click the link. Bye-bye.